متعوده كنا بشاك روكي يعني
خليلي
انت كمان
هو خليلي
ده عارف بفكر عم هي الوحيده حرام حلال لحالها الكل وقف This is Syria. Palestine. Having a blast. Yalla. الشاطئ عن جد كتير كتير حلو بتجنن ننزل This is Netanya Beautiful Our family coming out soon This is gorgeous Gorgeous Look at the water Look how clear the water is
احنا هسه في ربوع الوطن
مزبوط
انا وعلوش في ربوع الوطن بعد ربوع كاليفورنيا نحن الان في ربوع الوطن هللويا
هللويا نتاني
that nibble on your dead skin. بياكلوا الجلد الميت. They come up to you. At first it's a bit of a shock to get something biting on you, but look how many of them there are and they're all around us biting on us. But they're just eating our dead skin cells. Or dead skin I should say. But this is beautiful. The Mediterranean, Netanya, family, 2015. I'll give you a walking tour of the city of my birth. Jerusalem. This is the city wall. Built by the Turks. You can see the original walls, foundations down below for the ancient cities. The city's boundaries have changed significantly over the last millenniums. The current city you see today was not the ancient Jerusalem, which many believe was actually built on an adjacent mountain. That's why archaeologists aren't able to find any remnants of what they say is the jeweled Jewish temples. They were not here, they were somewhere else. What you see today is primarily an Islamic city at its core. Saint King Solomon's quarries, where they pulled the famous Jerusalem stone to build much of this beautiful city. Now we're about to walk through the main gate. We call it Damascus Gate. In Arabic, Bab al-Amud. Such a special place, an extraordinarily beautiful city. You can see the tops of the Church of Sepulchre, where many believe Jesus was crucified and laid to rest. Others believe that it could have taken place in the Garden Tomb, which is actually behind us. What you will notice is many of the stories of the Bible, as we know it, there's many different beliefs where they actually took place around this city, so it's not shared as a place, single place I should say. Here's the main gate. Look how beautiful this gate is with its Quranic passages. This place is special. Assalamu alaikum shabab. Jabal Han. Al-Madinah. Damascus Gate. Look. Beautiful. See the old ancient wall below, the old ancient doorway of the old city, and you see the newer doorway. Jerusalem has been built over 7 times. So what you see today isn't necessarily what would have been present to Tawb al-Habib centuries ago. Here's the main doorway of the current city. This is believed to be somewhere around 500 to 600 years old. Imagine. Entering the famous souks. There's many souks that make up this beautiful city. I will take you into one of the main ones for those that are interested. I want you to see it through the eyes of those that are traveling within it. One thing I do want to point out is, heard throughout my life that I don't look so-called Palestinian. If you notice, the Palestinians come in every walk of life and every color. We are a mixed people. So take a look and you will see Palestine. From blonde hair, blue eye, to African black, we are all equally Palestinian. And it is the composition that makes this land one of the most beautiful and most diverse. These are the markets, though there are so many of them. The meat market, the fish market, the market of the valley, as they would say. I will show you how close I grew up between two of some of the holiest sites on earth, next to the Holy Sepulchre, as I had mentioned, where they believe Jesus, as we say, Yeshua or Isa, some believe he was crucified and laid to rest. And Masjid al-Aqsa, where Muslims believe Muhammad alayhi salam rose to heaven. The city normally is much more crowded, but due to the wall, many of the surrounding communities that would flood to the city for trade no longer can gain access. And this has obviously affected the economy, where you have a great deal of tourists that come, but many of the natives or locals are not allowed. Only the original Jerusalemite families tend to be present, along with a lot of people from Al-Khalil or Mount Hebron, where Abraham, our prophet, is also buried, alayhi salam.
على الشبكة. So what we're coming up on is a major intersection of which I grew up a few hundred feet from, first few years of my life. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. As you can see, Souq al-Attareen. We're going actually to the Holy Sepulcher. This is the beginnings of the Hart al-Nasara, or the Christian quarter, where you see the pilgrims coming out is what we're about to enter, which is the Church of the Holy Sepulcher. And right above it you see Manara, Masjid Umar, where it's believed Umar al-Khattab, when he freed Jerusalem, they were asked him to pray in the church and he refused out of respect, fearing that in the future it will be asked for as a place of historical interest. Instead, it is believed that he took a stone and threw it, and where it landed, a mosque was built. And this is now called the Mosque of Umar. As you can see, here we enter the heart of Christian Jerusalem. The keys of the door of this fabled church is actually in the hands of two Muslim families, ancient families. People don't understand as many of the Palestinians have Christian and Jewish roots. Here we are. We gain unfettered access. Welcome to the Holy Sepulcher. This is where they believe Jesus was laid to rest, alayhi salam, on this stone. Many come to pay their respects.
I as well.
As he is revered in Christianity and Islam. Now watch the access. These are the stones of one of the oldest churches on earth. I will take you into amazing places. See, religion at its heart is about humility, not grandeur. Beautiful mosaic. So the church is divided into various areas: Orthodox, Ethiopian Orthodox, Armenian Orthodox. You can tell by the structure and its form that it is of Armenian, and also the Armenian writing also an obvious giveaway. But this church has many different denominations that make up the Christian religion, and each has its own area. At times they have conflict and they fight. Part of why the Muslims have the key is to have a disinterested third party that will open up access for all. And not one can claim title over the complete church. Stone foundations. Many come here to seek solace and to be closer in worship.
we will help you gain access. It's an old ancient church, and here it is believed to where the Holy Spirit rises. Extremely special to my family. I haven't really shared this with a lot of people, and I honestly do it humbly. But my last name is Dawoodi, which means David in Arabic. And the reason we bear that name is many believe that we were given custodianship over the tomb of David. Therefore, we took on the name of the area that he is buried, and many believe the Last Supper of Jesus took place on the second floor of that home. I am to show it to you. You will see it was seized violently in 1948 in what we call the Nakba, or the disaster where European Zionism befell this land and drove it into the calamity that we still see till this day. The walkways of the old city are extraordinarily unique and beautiful. So you see the Dejani name. My family is called Dawoodi Ad-Dejani. It's considered an ancient Jerusalemite family. Maqdusiyin, as they would say in Arabic. We are of the city, from the city, and it very much is a part of our collective histories and holds a very special place beyond just its religious significance, but also its historical significance and the shape that it would have on humanity that would, as we well know, exceed well beyond its small borders. Assalamu alaikum. Salam. Salam. Salam.
So we greet ourselves and each other with Salaamu Alaikum. Salaamu Alaikum, Ami. Which means peace unto you. And they respond with unto you be peace. Assalamu Alaikum. As you can see, most of the shops are owned by Palestinians, so both Muslims and Christians. We are one family here. No divisions between religions. We see ourselves as one, and that will not change. You can't tell the difference. Some will respond with unto you with peace, some will respond with barakah, which indicates to me that they're Christian, just basically telling us with blessings as well. Assalamu alaikum. City is very much still Arab in its core. This is what many call the Tower of David, although it has nothing to do with David itself. It was built by the Turks a few hundred years ago when this was under the Ottoman Empire. We are now going called the Armenian Quarter. It is the smallest quarter in Jerusalem. Many Armenians fled to the city for safety, and Armenians under the Ottoman Empire found refuge in many of the Arab nations in Palestine and Lebanon, and have become family for a lot of us as we welcome them into our land, and they have resided for over millenniums in some cases. So we're in one and the same. See the Armenian flag. We have idiots like Kim Kardashian, or God bless Israel and her stupidity. This tends to be the ignorance that you find in much of the United States. Have no knowledge of history or purpose. Here we're entering the old neighborhood of my family. There's a place of religious significance every couple of feet here. So I'm not gonna enter every church, but the point of all this is to give you a brief introduction and a place that I hope you come and visit with Phoenician Voyager. You learn the history of this wonderful, beautiful city. So you see the church tower. Behind that tower is where many believe King David, Nabi Dawood, as we say, is buried, and where my family's roots comes from. It is not about who you're born to, but what you do in your life. But there are some here that take legacy extremely seriously, and because of it, treat you differently. It's to our benefit in this city, but I've never bought into that myself. I still think it's the individual. But So now the area has been seized by Zionists, so you will see a lot of Hasidim Jews praying in it. Many of the ancient Palestinians actually were the original children of Israel, but they have moved on as they believe the Messiah came, Jesus. Most today are Muslim, but their appearance looks nothing like what you would imagine as the original Arabs did. You might see some sad images coming up ahead of some destroyed tombstones of my family and complete utter disrespect of our holy sites, which is why the anger emanates so much from the people. They wonder why we could be so upset when we have a people that have come to destroy ancient history, to resupplant it with their own form and doctored history. It angers those that have roots in Islam for thousands of years preceding many other religions. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Entering the neighborhood of my family. Let me show you something too, just to give you an idea of 1948 when they attacked. You could see the bullet holes. The marks still left till this day. They completely damaged the walls trying to come in. They did not enter in 48. In 67 they would take over the old city, but 48 obviously is the beginnings of the war. Here we go. This is our roots and a place that we hold dear and hope to be returned one way or another to our family and our roots, where Muslims, Jews and Christians live together in peace, as we hope they will again one day. Welcome. There's Christian pilgrims, even the Hagasion. And here we enter, right there, the tomb of David, and what is believed to be upstairs with the place where the Last Supper was held. And I will show you the Quranic inscriptions along with my family's inscriptions. And history cannot be denied. This is the castle that my ancestors lived in. Here's the room of the Last Supper. You see the Quran. The castle of my family. And, unfettered access we gain. You could see the old homes. It has now been turned into a synagogue. Here is the grave of my ancestors. You can see many of the tombs. around ancient ancestors. This is an Islamic cemetery.
It's beautiful.
Much of it has been allowed to just fall to waste, unfortunately. But we hope it will return as it once was ours. It's a highly charged emotional place for myself. Take you upstairs to where I may believe the Last Supper took place. I'm keeping my voice down because people are praying. See, the ancient natives are very tolerant. The new arrivals are not. These are our old homes. Now they've been converted into yeshivas. Let me take you to a place. I believe the Last Supper took place here. These are the grounds of my family. Grant individual access too much here, but as you can see here, the Last Supper room, the Quranic inscriptions, the place of direction of prayer. Here it is believed the Last Supper took place. Whether or not, I don't know, but it is believed so. Cases they removed some of the Quranic structures, but you can see God will not be removed under any circumstance. This is a land that is thousands of years old and holds too much significance. It's hard to put into words its importance. This door is like, you can hear the Quran. This is the Adhan, the call to prayer.
show you the Al-Aqsa Mosque as well. You know, without a doubt, that is the most beautiful structure in Jerusalem and quite possibly the world. It was the first piece of major Islamic architecture. And there's the roof of it. Here's what we call Al-Manara. Some call it Sum'a. This is Jerusalem, ladies and gentlemen. Here it is. You hear the Adhan? You can see how intermingled the places of worship for Christianity, Judaism, and Islam. That is Silwan, a Palestinian community under siege. As many of them are, as you can see, the city is very much Palestinian in character, especially the core of Jerusalem, the real Jerusalem. All right, I'm gonna take a walk, and next I'll show you Al-Aqsa. Beautiful. As you can see, unfettered access, Jerusalem. If you come with us, you will see it all, I promise you. Well, this is where it's believed Muhammad alayhi salam led the prophets in prayer on the Sakhra, which is this golden dome, houses the sacred stone which may be believed he rose to heaven from. We're also looking at what is considered the Wailing Wall or Western Wall, where some Jews believe was built by Herod, but it was through an archaeological dig that they had found an actual coin below, which was from a period after Herod. So it says that this wall was actually built after the period of Herod and could not have been part of the temple. So archaeology is actually changing the view of what maybe history is trying to teach of this area. Anyway, we're going to try to gain access into the Western Wall. Here's the Western Wall and the Wailing Wall. This plaza was built over a destroyed Palestinian area called Hart al-Magharba, which means the neighborhood of Moroccans. During the time of Salah ad-Din or Saladin, many Muslims came from what is Al-Andalus, Spain, and Al-Maghrib al-Arabi, areas of Morocco, Tunisia, and Algeria, to come fight along Saladin to liberate Jerusalem from the Crusaders. The Wailing Wall, as you can see, is divided into two areas, one for women and one for men. So in prayer, both Muslims and Jews share the similarity that when it comes to time of prayer, that we should be separated. So we focus on the prayer instead of just gawking at each other, as humans naturally do, which made sense. When I was younger, I was wondering why, but as I got older, you know, they know what they're talking about, believe me. You can see right above is Manara al-Aqsa. Now I need to wear the yarmulke out of respect for the holy site. She'll put it on. So you see, they wash as we wash and we pray. Similarities are obvious. Kippa. So enter the Wailing Wall. On fettered access. Hayat. Salaam alaikum. To heaven, and where he met his Lord, our Lord, and was introduced to all the prophets and led them in prayer down below Al-Aqsa. But this place, pictures does not do justice. You have to see it in person. It is without a doubt amazingly beautiful. This structure is well over between 12 to 1300 years old. The Crusader seized it for a period of time and converted it to a church. When the Muslims took it back, it was returned back to a mosque, and has been so since. It is a piece of architecture It is breathtaking. Here are the grounds of one of the holiest sites on earth and one of the most contested pieces of property in the world. Jews believe. It's hard to say the Jews because many of the Palestinians actually have ancient Jewish roots, but the European Jews believe that the temple stood here, but archaeology keeps proving them wrong. The temple stood somewhere else and was destroyed. This is a newer Jerusalem that you are looking at. Look at the beauty and the majesty of Qubbat al-Sakhra. And I'll see, at times it can be difficult to film inside, but we shall see inshallah here. It is a beautiful piece of architecture. We Muslims, we remove our shoes when we enter a place of prayer out of respect. Side of the dome. So I'm wearing shorts as it is about a little bit over 100 degrees and it's super hot. Generally you're supposed to wear longer pants, but you know, you play the rules, they'll allow you. You just have to know how to talk to them, and when they ask for the last name, it tells them where you're from, so they immediately know. As you could see, my last name, again, I don't use it as any reason, but it just gains access that many people will tell you that it's difficult. What I mean by that is filming and walking around places. You can see that legacy plays a role in this ancient city. Again, I don't buy into it, so please, I say this humbly, I don't buy into any of it, but for some it means a lot, so I do respect the contributions of my ancestors to this wonderful city, and I will never disrespect their honor. I just don't want it to be sort of a carte blanche, just walk around and do what I want when I want. I still have to honor their legacy, and I do. But here is the inside of the Dome of the Rock. This dome has been under some construction for some time, but if you can look up above, you can see the gold gilded, which is still being worked on for a long time to reinforce it, and it is just majestic. These pictures, I believe me, do not do it justice. You have to walk its grounds and smell the scents and be around your kin to understand. This is, I'll take you downstairs where many believe the Prophet rose to heaven. Some come here to get a hole under her. I will show you how we do it.
والله يعلم أن شعرات الرسول موجودة فيها وفي بخول شعر الرسول موجود بقوله هيك بس إنه هو بخول وبتسمي بالله بتحطه على وجهك يعني الله يعلم إذا مزبوط كلامه بس هيك الحكي هذا هو يعطيك العافية
They say the prophet's hair might be in one of those encasings inside. See, to us the Prophet is a man and not to be worshipped, so we are very careful, but some kind of take it to a whole different level and I try to be cautious. Anyway, here's below. I will be quiet.
now, and I will show you down below grounds. I've exited the structure. It's a balancing act here, respect worshippers. And also, I don't want to take advantage of the access I may get. Not that I'm special, please. I just, you know, I definitely don't want to. So this is Al-Aqsa. So behind me is the Sahra. And on Friday, actually, this is the place where the women pray. So if you ask me, between the two structures, you could see that the women actually get to pray on a higher ground in the most beautiful structure on the grounds. The men pray below in this structure, called, which is actually called Al-Aqsa, which is believed where the Prophet led many of the other prophets in prayer. Now this structure in front of you is actually relatively new. The original Al-Aqsa is below. As we've traveled the world, you could see that many of the current structures we see today are not the original structures in their times. Down below is the original Al-Aqsa. This is also a flashpoint, as the Israelis are trying to gain access in order to allow Jews to pray on these grounds. And the situation is compromise in the past has led to complete utter taking over of respective sites. So that's why it's not a matter of lack of compromise, it's fear that keeps us holding on to everything, and we don't feel that there's a compromise with those that don't compromise with you. They will ask you to give up what they themselves will not, so there's no reason to give up any grounds. And you will realize this is the native sometimes. Some of the Arabs, which are, some of them are generally recent in the last few centuries, might walk around thinking they have an entitlement complex, but they know that the actual native Philistines are not meant to be toyed with. We're not them. So in time they grow up to respect the history. The irony of this not can be disrespected by many people, many different faiths. I'll show you inside when the time is right. This is just a time of prayer, so. Somebody, Moses, Nabi Musa, is buried. What you have up here, like upstairs, is the summer or winter homes, I should say, because in the winter, here being in the Jordan Valley, the desert is much warmer. And obviously the hills of Jerusalem, which is at a much higher elevation. So they come here to be around increased heat. So these homes are not really much in use anymore. Basically were winter homes, and my family had one here. You're still able to use them, but they're just not in use as much anymore. Show you an Islamic cemetery, the surrounding cemetery of the desert, and the Jordanian border is about 10 kilometers. We're not very far from it at all. Palestine is a Turkish flag all over the place. Turkey in the last few years has shown a more positive role in the Palestinian conflict, from donating financial resources and coming to assist. No situation's ideal. They still share trade with Israel, but nevertheless, any help is better than no help. And here are the grounds of the desert. This is the Jordan Valley, beautiful desert. Out here, you'll see the Bedouins. Bedouins are nomads in basically move from area to area and allow their livestock to feed on the foliage of what area may be lush at the time. But with being nomadic traders, they tend to still retain their lifestyle, which is very simple, and still living as they have for thousands of years. And most refuse to actually live in settled homes. Over those hills is Jerusalem, which is much more lush and green, and it's quite interesting how in a matter of a couple kilometers you can go from extreme desert to relatively lush forests. So I took back one of the units. As you can see here, they are significantly cooler than the outside. It's just a relief from the immense heat, which can get into the 120s in Fahrenheit and close to the 50s in Celsius. Which is where, again, as I mentioned, they believe the prophet Moses is buried. Moses was the prophet who led the children of Israel, which is the person Jacob, whose name was changed to Israel, into the promised land or the holy land. All Jews, Muslims, and Christians believe this, but the debate that's raging is who are the children of Israel? And DNA analysis has shown that the actual native Palestinians have more in common, or they actually are, in many cases, the children of Jacob, as opposed to Jewish European converts who fortunately have hijacked the religion and turned it into a political tool. This tool is called Zionism, which many of the original believers do not adhere to. The shrine room, and this is where they believe the prophet Moses is laid to bury. When we're over a gravesite, we pray with the Fatiha, which is the opening chapter of the Quran. And one of the famous meals or delicacies, grape leaves wrapped or filled with rice and meat, or just rice alone. You'll find this in many, many homes and many places where vines extend everywhere. This is the Mediterranean, cuz. Check that out, huh? Look how beautiful. This is Yaffa. We got family here, we got friends, we got everybody, we got everything we need. We don't need anything else. It's gorgeous out here. Check this out. We're about to hit. Yeah. Hey.
بس اشوف الحجر هاي في حجرات ما تدفعني برودو اوكي I just want to make sure ما في حجار هون شكله ما في حجار
الوداع صديقي اعطيني الكاميرا اختيار
بس ما تبع حطها هيك
لا لا خليها معك
تمام تمام كيف غميقة امشي لها هيك غميق
ظهري فرمش شايف شو بصير فيي
كل يوم اسمع غميقة ده يلا Don't leash. مش غميقة. All right, we're recommending not to jump, so we're gonna slide in.
Let's do this.
Yeah, you're right, man. مش غميقة. No, لا لا, man. طلع. This is the Mediterranean cuz يلا حبوب عيد ميلادك ما ماشي ماشي love it we're the only stupid ones out here but we love this
نحن ايه
دكتور يلا
والله حلوة يا زلمة
شو this is sick this is beautiful ولا لا يا زباد come on man
انت الليكر هنا
شوية شباب
يا والله
شوية
اوكي
اوكي
ان شاء الله خير موجود
ان شاء الله خير برو
ان شاء الله
ان شاء الله خير برو والله العظيم
مرة حلو ان شاء الله خير